His next bout on the evening takes place over three rounds for the Eeyore Welterweight Championship. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, representing MMA Cork and bringing to the cage a record of 6 wins and 2 defeats, give it up for Paul Buckley! And introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, representing Sanda and bringing into the cage a record of 6 wins and 3 defeats, presenting Jess the Cobra Paolo!
Welcome back, Paul Brown, Andrew McGahan here. This is the first of five amateur title fights.
Five title fights, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, 5 in a row. Yes, the Cobra Paolo on a 3-fight win streak. A very, very busy man.
Paul Buckley in the opposite corner from MMA Cork. It's always great to see the two Maguire brothers sitting here to our right in the corner. And nice upward knee there from Jess, but we've been pretty high on both of these guys over the last while, to be honest. Jess is a very consistent, evolving fighter over the last year, and Paul is just a bit of a brute that we've liked ever since the first time we've seen him fight.
6th fight this year, he's been busy, as has Jess, of course. Both guys exceptionally talented grapplers, very dangerous.
Seen Jess throw himself in the deep end a couple of times as well at Grappling Industries events and doing the open weight absolute and stuff like that, and coming up against significantly higher skilled guys, but still giving it everything that he can and competing regularly in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu competitions as well. He's upskilling.
Chasing this takedown with everything he has, but great takedown defense so far. Paolo finds himself on his back now. Can he recover?
He's Yates in this. It's not even, you can't even call it like a half butterfly position, Yates. It's nearly like a...
Yeah, it's regular butterfly now.
Yeah, it is now. Buckley was working towards what would look like a body lock pass, and he just doesn't have the hands clasped underneath the lower back, which is what you'd need to try and clear the leg here a little bit smoother. But we'll also give a shout to Corkman as well, friend of Mr. Buckley, John Mitchell, with an impressive win over in India, the other night. Third round TKO. So nice to see him back in the win column. Strong overhook from the close guard from Paolo here, and a double overhook there, I think, for a second, to be honest, but could be a triangle setup coming here. Oh, Helio Gracie smiling from his grave. A heel strike from the close guard.
Love it. You'd love to see it.
I felt that I wanted to mention something about Helio's grave, because when I was talking about the 10th planet rubber guard earlier on, I should have said that he was spinning in his grave.
Good shots from the bottom here by Jess Paolo. Now he's over that arm and he's forced Buckley to backstep over. Good guard attention by Paolo. Paolo 6-3 record. Lost his first two bouts and went 6-1 since. Buckley is 6-1 since losing his debut back in 2018. So both guys running through most of the opponents that are put in front of them.
Yeah, it's very strange to think that, like, the amount of fights that we've seen on this event over the last while, there's a very good chance that a lot of these guys are going to come against each other at pro again in the future. And I know there's always been a thought process that you want to keep Irish guys away from each other at pro, like let them build up their record against other people and then they can compete against each other. But because of the volume of amateur fighters that are just taking everything so seriously and so diligently, it's probably inevitable that within 2 or 3 years you're going to have a very competitive domestic pro scene where it's going to be way more common and accepted for these guys to fight at 0-0, 1-0, 2-0 and stuff in their pro careers.
Yeah, absolutely. The next evolution now will be shows like this to have more pro fights on the card. And
no, the next evolution, or the further evolution, is when we get journeymen, like 0-30 pro fighters, like they have over in the UK. That's all Ireland is missing.
Yeah, I'm really, really looking forward to that.
I'll start fighting if that happens.
And for a few quid, lad, for a few quid. We'll go again. Buckley put on a good pace to get the takedown in the first round. We get past the striking of Paolo a second time.
Yeah, and do you know, Paolo seems to be more confident in the striking, and now he instigates the takedown of his own.
He might be on the back here.
Buckley's literally just stood up in that position. That's a serious show of strength there.
Paolo is no small fighter, and he just climbed straight back to his feet like there was nothing on his back. Yeah, I was just looking at the warm-up area, and Paolo was hitting pads, and teammate Armin Hercik said, "I've just been out of the gym for 2 weeks and I can see already a massive difference in how he's striking." And like I said, an ever evolving fighter. Paolo, another man who has lost to Nathan McGillion.
Catch and flies a little bit here, Paul. Sorry about that. I just caught myself in the tally up there. Can you see that?
I can. Yeah, yeah. I can see us there. Looking focused, handsome, tuned in, professional.
Oh! He went for the throw. Paolo kept a leg inside, which is what's given him this situation here. We could see either a back kick or we could see a reversal. Lovely use of the left foot in there to try and get the right hook in, but Buckley's doing very well. Even if he's conceded the bottom position there, he was about to have his back taken.
Yeah, and now he has his legs back between him and Paolo, which is what he wants.
His back against the cage too, so I wouldn't be surprised to see him just stand up from this position again.
Scrambled very well. Paolo putting on a good showing here in the first couple of minutes of round two.
Hard for us to see here. I know he has both hands under the back. Sorry about that, Paul.
We've got TV screens
everywhere. I was just wondering if he had one of the arms connected, but I wasn't sure if he did or not. But it's a good position for Jess to be in here. He can wear on Paul a little bit. He's never really showed signs of tiring in any fight that I've seen him in. Both guys are growing into this, but Jess should be looking to try to feed that left hand under more to get the wrist control here, but he's probably happy with this half guard position. Maybe try to pull his back out from the cage a wee bit so he could land a few strikes.
Bullying Buckley a little bit now in this position. And very strong second round showing for Paolo. This fight could conceivably be all square now going into the third one. Big knees to the body.
Just at the belt.
Good very knees big knees.
Yeah, very good strike. Not something you see too often.
And in that awkward spot where you're taking shots to the liver. Can't be comfortable.
So Jess made the decision that round. Like you saw at the very end when he was happy to open up to go for certain things. But that's when Buckley was able to create the momentum for him to get up himself. So Jess may have done the right thing there in terms of control over that round. You have to imagine that, like just after based off how the first round it went there with in terms of Buckley's grappling, I do think that if Buckley comes out here, he sets the pace and he sets the tone. Like Jess just threw a curveball at us in that second round by him being the one to instigate the takedown from the body lock, got on top and then didn't lose that position full stop.
Yeah, he looked very, very effective in that top position. That's all to play for now. Welterweight title on the line. Both guys have been steaming through a lot of the welterweights in Ireland and they're here meeting now, chasing this belt. It comes down to this third and final round, I think. Big left hand from Buckley. Big knee up the middle from Paolo. Buckley got that underhook just at the right time in that exchange.
Yeah, this is what Buckley's looking for. He's going to bring him down. Jess could have a triangle here if he's quick enough. No, but Buckley's passed to the left hand side. There could be back exposure here, or if Jess keeps this like headlock position, he could end up coming up and turning Buckley over, which is what he's going to go for.
Yeah, he's getting like a scarf. It's like a scarf hold, but
bulldog. Yeah, bulldog type choke.
It was enough to get back to his feet. Buckley's closed that distance instantly.
Yeah, there's a level of urgency in Buckley here in this one, because I think he might have been told in between the rounds that like we're after dropping that one. I don't know how the first one went, so let's put an exclamation mark on this one. Jess is on the neck a wee bit here, but he's not
nothing with any real threat.
Buckley's looking to just suck this space out from underneath. He has great control of Jazz's right leg there, right foot. Now he's looking to step in. This is out.
Almost got reversed, and now almost gets the back in that transition. Paolo stands up.
Nice, the weight and pressure that Buckley was putting down there caused Jess to kind of cave in as he was building himself up. He's trying to get his head to the other side of Jess here, which is what he wants. There is one arm on the face. It's not under anything. But there's some good hand fighting going on here between the two.
Oh, an uncomfortable squeeze.
This is going to be a big squeeze from a big man from Cork.
Jaw crush.
Probably a farmer in a past life.
Paolo goes 2-on-1 and just scrapes it off. This fight could be edging away from Jess Paolo as we enter the final minute.
Yeah, and it just has come down to the urgency of Buckley starting this round. Getting ahead in a couple of key transitions. I think Jess is one of the more improved fighters that I've seen over the last 12 months. Similar to what we said about Sarah Carney and Sean O'Bannon earlier on, having himself an arm and to train and motivate each other is a big help for both. You kind of just need that sometimes. This is a nice clinical performance from Paul Buckley. He's not making any major mistakes at the end here. Jess is trying his best to escape.
You find yourself in a bad position with a fighter of Paul Buckley's ability, and in a short 3-minute round it's very difficult to get out of there with enough time to swing that round back in your favour. Difficult to see from our angle or from the camera what exactly is happening. If he's under the chin, I don't think he is. There's the time.
Great fight. Good show of respect between both lads in the centre of the cage. The corner of the cage as well. Yeah, Darren bringing Jess up to his feet. Both men tired in this situation, but it's a great fight between both of them.
Gentlemen, all three judges have scored this bout the same, 29-28 for your winner. And now, your welterweight champion, Paul!